हेलो हेलो डैम हेलो डैम, नाउ
यस सर,
वॉइस इज इकोइंग, वॉइस इज
नो
रिपीटेड,
सर, नो सर,
नॉट
ओके
नाउ वॉइस इज नॉट रिपीटिंग.
नो सर.
I think now the voice is not echoing, right?
No, sir.
Okay, then we'll proceed the class. I think there is a problem with this Zoom app. I don't know. Stop recording. Meeting pause recording. Okay, fine. Now the screen is visible. We'll continue the class then.
So voice is low, sir.
Voice is low.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now it's clear, na? Voice and the screen is.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then coming to green walls, why it's used to cover the ugly sites in the garden area. Here, the green walls are constructed using the low brick walls, about 60 to 90 centimeter, or 1 to 1.2 meter height. Here, to break the daubness of concrete or the brick wall at the least is more prominent places, one can grow the creepers like ficus repens. If you want to cover the your old walls of your house or any offices, you can go for the ficus repens. This is a very important you say creeper which grows on the wall. It has a specialized root structures which climbs on the tree without the support of any media. So you need to remember this ficus repens for the green wall. Further, these are all the green walls constructed using the brick walls. This was the site we are discussing, the old walls. Then further, garden fences are also important components in the gardens. These fences are made up of wood, bamboo, wire nettings, chains, and other plants. Here, why the garden fences are needed? To make the boundary or for the protection or to separate one part of the garden from another. These are the garden fences. These are wooden garden fences. These are iron grills. Then, how to lay out the wire fencing? You know how to lay out the wire fencing, how to dig, how to plant them. Apart from that, apart from the non-living things like wood, irons. Apart from that, we can use the elegant creepers such as begonia, honeysuckle. This is very important. Lanisora, this honeysuckle and begonia, vernonia, morning glory, railway creeper, golden showers. These are all very frequently used in the garden fences. Then garden steps. These are also very necessary to have the steps in the garden. So for example, the paths goes on one level to another level to climb the any terraces in the garden. So mainly the steps are made from concrete, stones, woods, gravel. Then usually in between the steps we use the grasses, so it should be avoided. Why? If you water them, the steps will become slippery, so the problem will be there. So these are the some of the examples of garden steps. Then garden drives and paths. Garden must have a carriage drive leading to house or a garbage. So we use different parts of the garden. So the garden drives or the paths should be essential in the any garden. These are the garden drives made up of concrete bricks. And for the garden paths, path in the garden should be laid out after due to consideration given to its necessary aesthetic appeal. We should also emphasize on the aesthetic value of the garden paths. So you see this. These are all the garden paths laid out in the lawns. So here they have considered the aesthetic value of the garden and also the mobility. So we need to reach many corners of the garden. So the garden paths also laid out like this. And further, these are all made up of gravels as of concretes. Then further, hedges. This is important concept. Hedge means what? Any shrub or a tree planted in regular interval to form a continuous screen. It is called hedge. H-E-D-G-E, hedge. Here we mainly consider the plants like succulents, cactus, and sub-shrubs for the beautification. These are the examples of shrubs, hedges. Usually the edges will be height compared to edges. There are two edges in the garden. These are the edges. Then what is the purpose of edge in the garden? It serves as a compound wall. It gives the shelter for the strong gales or the strong winds. It ensures the privacy in the garden. It also forms a background for the flower display. Then it will separate the one compound of garden from another. And it will screen the ugly part or unwanted spot in the gardens like manure pits and many others. Then what are the criteria for selection of a hedge plant? Mainly it should, in the hedges we have two types. One is protective and another one is ornamental. For protective, protective means it should protect against the theft, tree process and winds. So coming to main characteristics, how should be a protective hedge? It should grow quickly, hardly, it should be hardy so that it can withstand the drought. Then it should be thorny and dense growing, and it should respond quick, frequent pruning and clipping. It should be can be raised quickly by seeds or cuttings, and it should have also the ornamental look so that we can use in the garden. I hope the voice and the screen is all clear. You're
yes,
following, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, these statements are very important with respect to the in your competitive exams. They will give some 3 to 4 statements, and they will give in the assertion and reasoning type questions or true or false type questions, and they will give in the match the following also. So further, how should be a ornamental hedge? What are the criteria? Ornamental hedge should be very attractive in foliage, and it should grow densely. Then it should withstand the regular clipping or pruning or trimming. And it should, the ornamental hedges generally low in height and do not obstruct the view completely. These are the important criteria. Then coming to classification of hedges. One is tall protective hedges. It ranges with a height of 1 to 3 meter. Tall protective hedges. Here, 1 to 3 meter height of hedge is constructed. Mainly the carica. Carica means corunda and bougainvillea, acacia. These are all tall protective hedges where the thorn is there and mainly used for the protective purpose. Then dwarf protective hedges. Here, the dwarf shrubs are maintained about 1 meter height only. This is only restricted for one, maximum is 1 meter. Within the 1 meter only, these hedges will be trained. Here, the euphorbia, opuntia, agave, these are all mainly used for the dwarf protective hedges. You need to remember all these examples. So they are very much essential or very exact questions where you can expect in the mind the following type questions. Then tall ornamental plants. Here also the height will be maintained at 1 to 3 meter tall, and the plants used are Duranta species, Duranta plumaria, Variegata, Goldiana. Then for the Himalaya we use Lantana, Hibiscus, and Thivesia. These are all the important tall ornamental hedges. Coming to dwarf ornamental hedges, here the height is restricted to maximum of 1 meter. Less than 1 meter only will try in the dwarf ornamental hedges. Example, Acalypa, Clerodendron, Phyllanthus, Lantana. These are the some of the example. And another concept is edges. These are also very important components in garden. This edge, E-E-D-G-E-S. This edge means, this is mainly the lining or bordering of flower beds or the paths or the lawn and shrubberies with a brick, concrete or living plants. This is known as edging. This is mainly, what is the purpose of edge? Only lining or bordering of garden components. That's it. What is the edge? Edge. This is mainly used to screen the ugly part or for the protective purpose in the garden. This is mainly for lining or bordering of flower components. Then coming to types of hedge, mainly two types. Formal hedge. Formal hedge means mainly made up of non-living things like stone, bricks, tiles, and informal edges. Informal edges means mainly consists of living plants. These are all you consider. This is a carpet. Here, this carpet is lined out by a concrete line. This is called edge. Here also through stones. Here through living grass. Here through stones. This is called edge. This is the purpose of edges in garden. Then coming to characteristics of edges plant. Mainly the edges plant should be grow very slow. Means dwarf plant should be selected. Dwarf character plant should be selected. And should produce good number of lateral shoots. And capable of retaining the original shape after trimming also. Then formal edges. Formal edges means mainly the non-living things like bricks, tails, and in informal stones also come, concretes. Then in informal, mainly the grass edges are prominent one. The species used are Alternanthera, Duranta, Dwarf Acalypa. These are the informal edges used in the garden. Further, topiary. Topiary means it's an art of trimming the plants into different shapes, such as birds, animals, domes, umbrella, or creating the sculptures by clipping or trimming the tree shrubs or other sub shrubs in the garden. It's mainly art of making the different shapes or creating the different sculptures in the garden. This concept is topiary. Here, topiary is one of the oldest art, and nowadays it's becoming most popular in every city parks. Then we'll see, it is a Latin word. topiary is a Latin word. Topiary means creation of topiary. Topos means place. These are the different sculptures or animal genomes. These are all topiaries, structures. You will definitely find in all the city parks nowadays. If you visit Jantar Mantar, you will find the different topiary structures. The squirrel shaped, elephant shaped, rabbit shaped, giraffe, domes. Then what are the important characteristics of a topiary plant? This plant should be very quick growing in nature, and it should, the leaves should be small in size so that it can withstand the trimming and pruning. So it will merge with the genome which we have created, the sculptures which we have created. And the leaves should be green or yellowish in color, and ability to withstand the frequent clipping or pruning, and produces the very good number of lateral shoots. And the plant suitable for the topiary activities are Clerodendron, Durantha. Here Durantha primary, Variegata, Goldiana, these are all very important for the topiary activities. Then Juniperus also used, and Cupress, Thuja, these are all very frequently used for the topiary. For the temperate countries, the English ivy is the one of the best for the topiary activity. You remember, for the temperate countries, the species suitable for the topiary are box tree and English ivy. Then how to make a topiary? What are the special horticulture practices followed in the topiary activity? Mainly trimming, trimming, clipping, then giving a specific shape like sculptures and the animal shapes like that. Then another important component in garden is rock gardens. Rock gardens also called as rockery or alpine gardens. This is important. Rock gardens are also called as alpine gardens. It is a type of garden feature. Here, extensive use of rocks or stones along with the native plants or the alpine environment is exploited to create a local garden in the view. That's why we call the rock garden. Here, the majority of the feature will be a rockery or alpine environment. If you visit the Chandigarh rock garden, you will find the
extensive use means.
Yes.
Extensive use of rock means.
Means you observe here the in Chandigarh garden, the about 60 to 80% of the garden component is a rock. They use the ornamental rocks, are the locally available rocks and weathered rocks. In rocks only, they will use in different sizes, different shapes, different style, and different weathered condition rocks. And the only the about 10 to 20% of the other garden components are incorporated. Mainly the local plants or the fountains or the flower beds, the two only succulents, cacti, and bulbous plants. They extensively use the rocks, gravels, sand, like that. That's why the name itself indicates. Here the rock garden means here the rocks and the and its environment, dry environment is depicted more. Here in this Japanese rock garden, you observe what is there in this garden. Majority of the garden is rock. Different weathered rocks are there, gravels are there. Here the gravel, you see, they are arranged in a different manners. You see, this is like looks like a weathered rock, and the craveling water stream nearby the local flora. Like that only they will create the concept of rock garden. Then here you observe the sand and the stone garden located at Portland. This is also Japanese gardens. What is there in this? Some masses are there, except that only the rocks, different size, shape, and different weathered condition rocks are presented. These are some of the pictures from Chandigarh Rock Garden. You see the succulents. On the rock garden also, they created some falls-like environment. In the rock only, they created the different shapes, styles. You see here, human genomes also created there. Different colored rocks also. Here in the rock garden, we use bonsai also. How to select the site for the rock garden? It should be very natural. The garden should be selected where the natural rocks are available. The natural rocks will be the more component in the rock garden. And the local flora. Then what are the characteristics of rocks? How should be the rock? It should be local origin, porous, should be a weathered look. Then rock should have the diameter of 60 centimeter or more based on the situation. Then types of rockery, those are all not necessary. Coming to construction. In rock garden also, you will find many horticultural practices like weeding, staking for the newly planted tall trees or tall plants, watering, then dripping, then replacement of soil, manuring. And we'll discuss some of the important suitable plants for the rock garden, mainly the local native species like Rosandra, Cuffia, Zinnia, Gamphorina, Candytuft, this one, Vinca rosea, then shrubs like Calliandra. This is powdery puff, Calliandra, Clerodendron, and cacti and succulents like Polyetal. This is also very important, Ponytail palm, then Opuntia, Gava, Calancho, Sansevieria, Yucca, and ferns like Adiatum. Then shaded plants like Impatience, Balsam. These are very important. In gravel garden, rock garden, gravel garden, there's a slightest difference between the rock and the gravel. The true gravel garden is one situated on the predominantly gravel or sandy soil rather than simply planting on the soil mulched with the grass. Here the majority, predominant part will be gravel or sandy soil. This is the difference between rock garden and gravel garden. For your information, these two are different. They won't ask this much depth question, but you try to remember all these concepts so that it will be helpful further. Gravel size, quality, color, those are not necessary. then this carpet bedding is very important concept in garden component. What do you mean by carpet bedding? It means the covering of an area, preferably a bed or a series of bed with a dense or low growing herbaceous plant, to create a set of design. Here you remember, covering an area, preferably a bed, one bed or a series of bed. Here we use low growing herbaceous plant to create a design. This is called carpet bedding. Carpet means we use multiple cloths to create a carpet. Bedding means we use different carpets for the creating a design. Remember like that. Here we create different animal shapes, bird shapes, or any objective. What is the difference between carpet bedding and topiary? Topiaries are mainly created at a very, they were created at higher heights, in the different level of heights. Here the carpet bedding mainly created in lower heights. That is the difference. Carpet bedding should looks attractive in slopy lands. This is very important. Mainly carpet beds are done in the slopy lands. Here creating of figures or the letters with the plants having different growth habits or having the different colored leaves. This is also creating of figures and letters also done in carpet bedding. This is a flower clock. Flower clock is also a carpet bedding. Here we will use the different beds, flower beds, to create the flower clock. These are some of the examples for carpet bedding. How these are created? First we'll execute a design. How first we'll create a design. Based on that, we'll select some different plants, herbaceous plants, low growing herbaceous plants. Then we'll go for the execution. These are all the different designs. Then we can create the different seasonal carpet beddings also. As we earlier discussed in the flock track, the seasonal carpet bedding also done. The plant characteristic. How should be the plants which are used for the carpet bedding? It should be perennial in nature and retain good, better color contrast throughout the year. It should be very good in color and quick recuperative, means recover from the injury after the pruning and trimming. It should withstand the frequent pruning and moving. Some of the examples like Alternanthera, variegated, we have different leafed, like red, green, variegated ranges. Then dwarf coleus, these are all very important for carpet bedding. And this dusty miller also very important. This is the Alternanthera. These are different colored range dwarf coleus. Then flower bed. Apart from the carpet beds, if you consider one flower bed, this is one component in garden. If you consider the series of garden of flower beds, this is the carpet bed. That's it. The main idea of creating the flower bed in the garden is to display the flowers in the best way as it possible. Mainly we create the flower beds based on the season. If you want to create the winter flowering, summer flowering, rainy flowering flower beds, we'll choose the different perennial plants which are suitable for that season. Here mainly Kenna, Daisy are used for the flower beds. Here the shape of the flower beds may be circle, rectangular, square, oval, kidney shape. in this picture you can observe the zinnia flower beds, red salvia, tulip flower beds, then geranium, central geranium, then tulip beds, tuberose, goldenrod, ageratum. This is gerbera. These are all some of the example for the, these are all the plants suitable for the flower beds. Helichrysanthemum, dwarf marigold, gamphorina, calendula, kenna. Then shrubbery. This is also one of the important garden component. Shrubbery means growing of shrubs in a group. It's called shrubbery. This is a very important statement. Growing of shrubs in a group is called shrubbery. Here, shrubberies are the permanent features of garden, unlike seasonal flowers. These are shrubs. Here, Ixora is mainly used in the creating the shrubberies. Ixora coxiana, azalea. Then borders. This is also one of the important garden component. Borders means beds which have more in length than the breadth. They contain the plants with the heterozygous characters. Those are borders. Here in the borders also we have annual borders, herbaceous borders, and mixed borders. Annual borders means here we only use annual type of plants or flowers. Herbaceous border means here only the vegetative growing plants are the herbs are used. Mixed border means we use herbs, shrubs, annuals to lay out the borders. You remember the which are the important garden components. Then arch. Arch means it's a semicircular or rectangular in structure at the entrance of gardens or a building component. It's a structure at the entrance of garden. This is called arch. Then what is the minimum height should be? If the arch is there, what should be the minimum height? It should be 2 to 2.5 meters. It can be made up of wood, metal, or bamboo, or any other plastic also. The minimum height should be 2 to 2.5 meters. This is called arch, a rectangular or a semicircular structure at the entrance of the garden or a building. Is termed as arch. These are iron arch. Here on the arch also we can try in the different climbers. This is the climbing ropes. Then what do you mean by pergola? Pergola means it's the extension of arch or the consideration of length. If you consider this is the one arch, these are all multiple arches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are all the different arches interconnected to create a pergola. That's it. Series of arches is called pergola. What is the main use of pergola? Mainly used for rest. It is a mainly resting place during the summer months. Here we trying the many creepers on the pergola. Here also we use the materials like wood, iron, plants to create the pergolas. Then arbor. This is also one of the important garden component. Arbor means it's nothing but a hut like structure having more than 8 entrances. Here mainly the why the arbor is created in the garden, mainly to rest for the visitor. To take the rest, the arbor is created. These are all the arbor structures. then garden bridges. Then lawn. Lawn is also one of the important feature in the garden component, right? Lawn is also important garden feature. Apart from that, till now we discussed many other garden features. Can you name few of them? Yes.
Cynodon, Joycia.
Okay. Further.
Kentucky bluegrass.
Okay.
Korean grass.
Okay. I feel you have a little knowledge through regarding the lawn species. Okay, we will discuss in detail on the lawn in the next class. You please mind, these are all the important garden components with respect to for your competitive exams. Don't read in depth on these topics. You just remember the important definitions. What do you mean by arch, pergola, then topiary, hedge, shrub, like that. Then which are the suitable plants and what is the minimum height of the pergola or hedge. Then tall protective hedge, which are the suitable species, like that. You remember, this is enough for your competitive exams, right?
Yes, sir.
Then any other points to add for this discussion? Okay, right.
What's the difference between carpet bedding and flower bedding?
Carpet bedding, flower bedding. Carpet bedding, we have already discussed. Carpet bedding means, carpet means you consider carpet. What do you mean by carpet? There in the carpet, we can observe the different length of silk or threads. Many threads are grouped to create a carpet. In the mainly in the carpet bedding, the flower we can use the flowering species or the herbaceous species or the shrub species or the annual species. In the flower beds, here mainly we use the different flowering annuals or biennials. We don't use the herbaceous shrubs or the annuals. Flower bedding is mainly concentrated on displaying the different flower beauties in different seasons. Carpet bedding is mainly, here we mainly concentrate on, it's a perennial component in lawn. The perennial species only we use. Okay.
Yeah.
Here the flower bedding will be seasonally changes. It will changes seasonally. Once we grow marigold or different annuals like balsam, tulip, it will change depending upon the season. But the carpet bedding, it's a perennial one. If you use acalypa or thuja or any other shrub species, it will be perennial one. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, any other doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, if it's a case, we'll discuss in the next class regarding the lawn. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, then we'll close the meeting then.
Yes.